वेलकम टू मराठा विद्या प्रसारक समाजस के आर टी आर्स बी एच कॉमर्स एंड ए एम साइंस के टीचम कॉलेज नासिक। माई सेल्फ संपर्ण डेमसे वर्किंग एज एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक साइंस। डियर स्टूडेंट, वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस द चैप्टर टू इंस्ट्रक्शन सेट्स टॉपिक एड्रेसिंग मोड्स पार्ट वन। इन टूडेज वीडियो लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी addressing mode part 2. So in this addressing mode, an address mode is always locate the target data, which is also called as operand. The 8051 microcontroller family allow 5 types of addressing modes for addressing the operands. First one is immediate addressing, register addressing, direct addressing, register indirect addressing, and index addressing. So these are the types of addressing mode. In first video lecture, that is addressing mode part 1, we saw the immediate addressing and register addressing. In today's video lecture, we are going to discuss the direct addressing, register indirect addressing, and index addressing. So the pictorically we can represent this addressing mode like this. This is the addressing mode having 5 types. First one is immediate addressing. In immediate addressing, these are the example of immediate addressing instructions. MOV A, #24H. #24H is a special character, indicates that this is the immediate addressing. So MOV A, #24H, so the immediate byte 24H move in accumulator register. Similarly, this is the hexadecimal number and this one is a decimal number 255, that will be move in R3 register. So immediate data 55H in hexadecimal, that is immediately move in B register. MOV DPTR, the content of DPTR register will be the immediate data 1234H, hexadecimal data move in DPTR register. Add A, #23H, the immediate data 23H byte is added in accumulator, result is stored in accumulator register. So this is another instruction, add A, #68H, 68H is the immediate data that is added in accumulator register. So these are the instructions belongs to immediate addressing. So hash is the special character included at the data site. So this instruction is a immediate addressing mode instruction. The second one is register addressing. So register addressing means one operand is a register, means both operands are register, R1 and accumulator, move A, R1. R1 is the general purpose register, that data will be moved in accumulator register. Again a MOV R3, A data is moved in accumulator register, content of accumulator move in R3 register. Now this is the next instruction, that is add A, R4, content of R4 register, that is move in accumulator. Add A, R6, content of accumulator added with R6 register and data is move in accumulator register. MOV R5, A, content of accumulator move in R5 register. So in this way, these instructions all are having a register only. So that is why this instructions belongs to register addressing. So these two addressing mode we saw in addressing mode part 1 video lecture. Now today we are going to discuss the next addressing mode, that is direct addressing mode. And in this direct addressing mode, these are the instruction belongs. So in this direct addressing, one operand is from random access memory, and another one is register side. So one operand is given by random access memory and one is from register. So then that types of addressing we name as direct addressing. MOV R0, 10H. Now 10H is the address of random access memory. That address contained move in R0 register. MOV 55H, A. The content of accumulator is move in random access memory whose address is 55H. So MOV R3, 7FH. 7FH is a hexadecimal address of random access memory and that content is moved in R3 register. Similarly, add A, 44. The content of memory location, random access memory location pointed by 44H, that content added with accumulator and result is stored in accumulator. So this is addition instruction. Add A, 26H is the address of random access memory. That data will be moved in accumulator register. Result will be stored in accumulator register. So these are the direct addressing. Index addressing. In index addressing, the at is used over here and the address is from maybe from external memory or maybe internal memory. So here MOV at the rate A plus DPTR. The content of DPTR register plus content of accumulator register, that gives the index address, and from that content will be moving accumulator register. Or the MOV at A plus PC, A. The content of accumulator move in the address generated by A plus PC, program counter register, and that content, accumulator content, move in that memory location. Now this addition operation of accumulator plus this generated address. So this generated address will be A plus DPTR. So that value, that content value added in accumulator, result is stored in accumulator. So this is index addressing. Register indirect addressing or indirect addressing. So this addressing having this example here, the register RI means R1 and R0 are used to point the memory. So here MOV A, at R1, the value of R1 register give the address of memory location, from that memory location move in accumulator. MOV at the rate R0, A, the content of accumulator move in random access memory whose address is pointed by R0 register. ADDA, addition of accumulator plus this content. The content of random access memory pointed by R0, that is added in accumulator, result is stored in accumulator register. Similarly here, ADDA, at R1, the content of R1 register point the random access memory, that content is added in accumulator register, result will be in accumulator register. And this is a move instruction in memory location whose address is pointed by R1. The content of accumulator register move in random access memory whose address is indirectly pointed by R1 register. So this content get change, random access memory content change. So this at the rate indicates that this is the indirect addressing. Okay, so this is the indirect addressing. We have to see direct addressing, index addressing, register indirect addressing in detail in next slides. So direct addressing. In direct addressing mode, the address of data is specified as the operand in instruction. Using the direct addressing, we can access any register or on-chip variables. This is include general purpose random access memory, special function register, input output ports, control registers. Example MOV A, 56H. Here the data in random access memory location 56H is moved in accumulator register. Means this is the address of random access memory. That content is moved in accumulator register. So this addressing having the operation code format like this. This is operation code and then direct address like this. MOV R3 is the having operation code. So and E8 is the direct address. Specify data by 8-bit address usually for 30H to 7FH of random access memory. So this data will be stored. Now these are the some examples related with direct addressing. MOV 70H, that indicates copy the content of RAM at 70H to the accumulator. The content of random access memory pointed by 70H, that is moving accumulator register. MOV R0, 40H, the content of random access memory copied at 40H to accumulator register. MOV 66H, A, put the content of accumulator at 66H random access memory. It means the content of accumulator move in random access memory whose address is 66H. MOV D0, A, content of accumulator move in the memory location whose address is D0H. So these are the various instructions. Now data memory, internal data processing is like this, 00 to 1FH. This is a special purpose registers having 4 banks and total 32 registers we use as a general purpose register. Now how it is separated, we already discussed these things in detail. Then 20 to 3F. So this is the address of bit address random access memory, and 30 to 7F we can use as direct or indirect addressing. So this is the lower byte of random access memory 128. 80 to FF, this is used as upper 128 RAM indirectly address only. These are the special function registers and they can use as an indirect addressing also. So this is the internal data addressing space of random access memory. Here let us see one example in detail. MOV A, 56H. The content of random access memory whose address is 56H, that contain move in accumulator. Now how this will be executed, that we are going to discuss in detail. The content of accumulator change, but content of accumulator random access memory does not change, because this just copy the memory location content in accumulator register. So here this is the content of accumulator is nothing but the content of memory location pointed by 56H. Let us see the one example, that MOV, this is instruction MOV A, 56H, whose operation code is ECH, number of byte required 2 and cycle, machine cycle is 1. For that, so here before execution, this is the program memory, that is 4K program memory, and this started with address 00H and ended at 1FFFH, but we take a small portion of that. So this memory consists of, see here, see, two memory location required for store this instruction, that is MOV A, 56H, one for operation code and another is for 56. So these two memory locations required to store this memory, this instruction in program code memory. And now the content of program counter register. Now, as we know, program counter register always point address of next instruction which is to be executed. Now this instruction is going for the execution. Then this address is pointed by program counter register, means 0002. So this is the situation before execution. Register bank, that is register bank 00278 registers. These are the data memory content 128, started address 00H, end at 7FH, and in between that there is a 56. So here 00 to 7F means there is a one address 56H whose data is 68. So this is the content, 68 is the content of this memory 56. Okay, now this content move in accumulator. Okay, now the before execution the accumulator having 909H. Okay, this is the content of accumulator before execution. Now this is the situation for memory, program code memory, program status word register, accumulator, data register. This is the situation before execution. Now when this instruction executed, after that the situation will be like this. The content of accumulator get change. Okay, see here. So this is the 56 MOV A comma 56H. So this 56H contain, that is 68, that is moving accumulator. Other things remains as it is, no change in there. So this is the after execution the content of accumulator becomes 68H. Previously it was 90, now it becomes a 68H. So in this way this address contain move in accumulator. So this is about execution process. Now let us go through the next addressing, register indirect addressing. Here in register indirect addressing or indirect addressing, the operand is specified as the content of a register. Now this is having operation code and I indicates the value of that register. The only R0 and R1 allow indirect addressing or register indirect addressing. These register in the indirect addressing mode are called the pointer register. Okay, now this is an instruction MOV A comma at R0. Now this is the pointer register, points the memory, then random access memory, that memory contain move in accumulator. Okay, so this is the E6 is the operation code of this. The sign at the rate indicates the register acts as a pointer to the memory location. So this is the pointer to the memory location, and only two registers can point that memory, R0 and R1, not other register. MOV A comma at R2, this is invalid because only two registers can point the memory. So in indirect addressing, the address of source and destination is specified in register. Uses register R0, R1 for 8-bit address. Now these are the simple examples. MOV PSW at the rate 0 indicates PSW's registers all bits become 00. And this 00 means RS0 and RS1 is also 0, means bank 0 gets selected. MOV R0 hash 4CH. So this immediate 4CH data will be moved R0 register. MOV at the rate R0 comma 3. So it indicates that the content of memory pointed by 4CH now having 3. So the memory content 4C is having the content 3. Now these are the another examples, MOV A comma at RI. RI will be 0 or 1. Content of memory location pointed by register R1 or R0 move in accumulator. Similarly here, accumulator. We can use DPTR also. MOV A comma at the rate A plus DPTR. So this is index addressing. That content will be moved in accumulator. This content will be moved in accumulator. Like this, then DPT means higher byte content will be moving, content of accumulator moving DPTR pointed by higher byte. So here also content of accumulator moving memory location pointed by R0. So these are some examples related with register indirect addressing. Now let us see the examples, that is MOV at the rate R0. So the R0 symbol indicates the addressing mode is indirect, and if the content of R1 is 70, for example the operand in the internal memory location is 70. So 70, we assume that R1 having 70, so that 70 random access memory content move in accumulator. The content of random access memory 56H is 24, then 24 is move in accumulator. Let us suppose that address is 56, then that content is 24. So 24 will be move in accumulator. Let us see that example, MOV at the rate R0. So this having operation code E6H, 1 byte, and again this is machine cycle required is also 1. Now this is the program counter or program counter register who points the program code memory of 4K. Now here this address is stored, so our program counter register gives the address of next instruction, that is 0001. So this is the content of program counter register. Now as we know, suppose we want to use this bank, okay, bank 0, then PSW, programs status word register, RS0 and RS1 should be 00. When they are 00, then this bank, random access memory bank 00 to 07 gets selected. So this is the 00 to, this is having 00 content, address 01, 02, like this, this will be 07. So that bank gets selected. So this is a register bank, R0 we need. So these are the another banks, they are unused. Okay, this R0 having 70. Now this 70 is the random access memory address, and that is having 68. Now when this instruction executed, then this 70, okay, this 70 is the content of R0 that is move in accumulator register. Now this is the accumulator register. So this R68 is now the data of this memory that is move in accumulator. If you see before execution it was 9890H, and after execution it becomes a 68H. So this is the after execution content of accumulator, and before execution it is like this. So in this way this MOV A comma at the rate instruction executed. Okay, next one, index addressing. Index addressing, with index addressing mode, the effective address of operand is the sum of base register and offset register. The base register can be data pointer register or program counter register, while offset register is accumulator register. In index addressing mode, the only MOVC and jump instruction can be used. Now here this is the index addressing mode is useful for retrieving data from lookup table. So at the time of programming, we are going to discuss how the lookup table are used for retrieving data in main program. Move example, MOVC a comma at the rate a plus dptr. The content from operand is sum of the content dptr and the accumulator. This instruction, addressing instructions are like this. A register index mode, the source or the destination is the sum of base address and the accumulator. Now these are the instruction: MOV DPTR hash 00H, MOV A comma hash 6, and MOC A comma at the rate DPTR. Now DPTR having 000H immediate data, 8000H immediate data, and this is a offset for that. So these two get added. So that gives us the content of memory 8006, and that content is moved in accumulator register. Similarly here, ORG 100H means the origin of our program start from 100H means 1000H. MOV A comma hash, the content of accumulator now 5. Now what is the content of PC? The next instruction. So that instruction suppose having this content of accumulator plus PC. So here it is 4. Okay, no operation. It is indicating that content will be PC. So the PC having 2, next instruction content plus, sorry, 3 plus 8 means 1008. So 1008 is the address of memory from where the data will be moved in accumulator register. So this EC indicates external memory, external memory. So these are the example of index addressing. Now let us see examples related with index addressing. This is the instruction MOV at the rate A plus DPTR, and operation code is 2, number of memories machine cycle required to, and byte of address required to store this instruction is 1. So here this is the internal random program code memory 4K, and we can extend it up to 64K. Now when we write C, then external memory address generated. Okay, so here this is the program counter content, 93 is stored over here, and this gives the next instruction address 00001H. This is a bank, again data memory, DPTR having now the content 8002. So we need that DPTR content plus the content of accumulator. Now what is the content of accumulator? Content of accumulator is 04. So after that, so when this 04 and DPTR get added like this, so this is addition of this accumulator plus DPTR. So what is accumulator content? 008002. What is the content of accumulator? 04. That gives us 8006 in hexadecimal. So that is the address of program counter. So what is the new address of program counter? That is 8006, and that is the external memory address. So that address memory is 8006, and what is the content of that? A5H. That will be moved in accumulator. So this is the accumulator new content now. Okay, after execution it is A5H. So in this way, MOVC A comma at the rate A plus DPTR instruction executed. So this is after execution. Now let us see the another example, program counter register, MOV A comma at the rate PC. 93 will be the code for that. Now here this is our internal memory. Now if we use PC only, the next address gets selected. Now how it is? it is like this. Program counter register will be gives the next address 0001H, that content plus the content of accumulator that is added. Now here the content of accumulator before execution, suppose 05H, that is move, and added in content of PC. So the addition will be like this: 0001 program counter content, accumulator content is 5, so result will be 006. Now this 006H is the address of here 000. So how it is, you see here, this is the address pointed by this program counter register. This is a new address, and then that address content is 8, that is move in accumulator register. So this is the content of accumulator after execution, that is A8H. Okay, so this is the process of execution of MOV A comma at P plus PC instruction. Student, we already discussed the three types of addressing mode: direct, register indirect, and index addressing in this video lecture. I hope you may understand all these types of addressing mode. In university exam, the question asked on this topic: what are the types of addressing mode, and explain each addressing in detail. Or they give us instruction, and we have to identify the instruction according to their addressing mode. Thank you. If you have any question, contact on my mail ID sampadmc57@gmail.com. My WhatsApp number is 9860389302. Thank you.